Hi all, welcome to HTML for All series by VTalks. So in this video we are learning about image tags as well as hyperlink tags, how to apply image tags in different areas, how to apply hyperlink tags in different areas. So it's an easy thing, so let's go to the video. In this video we will be learning about how to insert images and about how to add hyperlinks in a web page. We'll go to the class. So for inserting images we are using a tag known as image tag, img image tag. So usually the syntax means how to give the tag is img src. Src means location of image file or source file. Okay, location of image file. And the image name, or you can say the folder name, in which folder the image is residing, and finally the image name with its extension. Okay, so these all things if you add in a web page you will get an image displayed on the HTML. For an image tag we have mainly five attributes. SRC, already I said, location of the image, that can be relative or absolute, which means that can be image that is inside the same folder of your HTML file, or image that can be outside it in another folder of the HTML file. Then alt, substitute text for display, which means if for with any reason the image is not displaying properly, instead of that a name will display. A name, you may have experience that when you take a website or something, okay, instead of image there will be a name because the image is currently not available. Then height, width, that is number of pixel of height and number of pixel of width, which means you can set a specific height or width for the image. Otherwise, if you are not setting height and width, the whole big image will come. I will show you in the example. Then border, size of border, 0 for no border. So if you need a border, black border or anything for the image, you can give border attribute. Okay, now we will go to the Notepad++ and create a page for that. So now this is a new HTML page. Okay, so I will show you in our HTML. This is the folder I am creating the HTML pages. So here I am going to create a new HTML page also, and in this folder you can see this folder is in this PC. When you open my stuff, official stuff, school stuff, 2021 video classes, HTML. So this is a folder. Inside that one more folder is there, image. Here some images are here. We will take any image and display it in a page. Okay, so first of all in the Notepad++ our normal tags we should give. Okay, so I will just start with the normal tags. Okay, I just typed some normal title, head, body and everything. Now we need to save it as HTML, same way, save as file, save as, select HTML from the list, give a name. So images, example, images example, save it. Now it's an HTML page. Okay, now I need to show this particular image in the web page. You know, you can see the size of the image, right? Here you can see the size is, dimension is 3840 into 2160 pixel. Okay, so let's add the image there. So first of all we need img tag. SRC is equal to image name we have to give. So first of all, we need to identify in which folder the image is there. So here it is in this much. You don't have to type, just click it, you will get it very easily. Copy, go to your page, put double quotes, paste. Okay, now one more slash you need to add because we didn't give the image name slash. Now go to images, here quote fancy this numbers.jpg, just copy it, just click on rename option, just copy the full thing, copy, okay, and paste it here. Okay, so the image tag is complete now. Okay, the whole folder name I copied it. Okay, nothing I did, nothing else, I copied it, copied the name, double quotes, tag close, image tag closed. Okay, now we will just check what is the result. Okay, run, login, crop. We can see a big image came, right? It is bigger than our normal screen size. Okay, big image came here. Okay, now how we can solve this, that we will study now. So already in the PPT we studied height width option. Okay, so we can give that height and width. Now so here with the SRC, before this SRC or after the SRC, wherever you can give, height equal to maybe we can give like 480. Okay, then width equal to 720. Okay, so height and width I set, save. Same, we can take the web page and refresh it. You can see it's set to the height what we have given here, 480 pixel height, 720 pixel width. I think you understood the concept of height and width. Okay, now next alt. Actually for showing the alt, how to change the you know that the image name here is something like this. Okay, so I'm giving the alt here. So alt image not found, I'm just giving image not found, alt is equal to, so you need to put is equal to image not found. Okay, so now here the image name is quad fancy. Okay, so the alt will work when the image is not present, for some reason image is not present. So for example, from the image name I just changed the image name, I changed it to ABC. Okay, that change is not affected in the here I am doing this same name. Okay, I am running the page with same name. So save it, after that I will refresh. We can see now the current image is not present because I changed the name. So instead of the image they have shown a message, image not found. Okay, so whatever we give in alt it will display in such cases. Okay, so that's how the alt tag is used. Okay, yeah, now border also, border tag is there. So for setting border, actually we changed the image name, so we have to come back to that name, actually abc.jpg. okay, so I am changing it here also, I am changing abc. For showing you, okay, for showing the border effect. yeah, the image came back. Now we will just give border. Border is equal to 0 for no border. By default it is 0. I am giving something, some numbers 10. Okay, just give a number. We will just check. Yeah, you got a black thick border around it. So according to the number you are giving, you will get that. Okay, yeah, so that's about the border tag. Now while giving the image names, how will you get the extension? You know extension, right? JPG, PNG, like that. How can you find out the extension? So if the extension is not showing here, you can just right click, take the properties, and it will show the extension here, JPG file .jpg, like that. Okay, so here my extension view is open, actually that's why it is showing the extension. So if you are using Windows 10, it is easy to show all the extension here in the view icon. One option is there, file name extension. So if you change the tick, you can see extension all gone. If you tick it, you can see extension came back. Okay, so for easy thing, you can do like that. Yeah, so that's about the image tag. I hope you understood. Now we will go to the next tag. Hyperlinks. That is another tag. Hyperlinks. You have seen in Wikipedia and all blue color underlined links, where you click, it will take you to another page like that. So those are hyperlinks. So hyperlinks are used to give a link to another HTML page in your current page. Okay, so you have a current page. You may have a current page, whatever page you are working, and if you need to add a link there, you can easily add with the hyperlinks. For that, the tag we are using is a tag. It's called anchor tag or a tag. The syntax is, syntax means the way to write. Open the tag, href, reference. Okay, reference page 1.html, which means the page you need to connect, the second page, what page you need to connect, that page name, full page name you have to give. Then click here to visit, which means a message will come with the underline, click here to visit. So if you click there, you can give anything there that will come there. Okay, so click here to visit, that page will come. So we'll go to that tag. We can use the same page, same notepad. Yeah, so here below the image I need to connect. For example, you can add any number of images. Okay, you can add any number of images anywhere in the web page. Okay, that's according to your wish. Now I only did the first one, that's all. Yeah, now for the h tag, for example, here we have some HTML pages already. We created the list page and all, right, and sample one and all. We'll just check what is the result here. Double click, open. So in the sample one, it's about trust and all. So we'll just connect this page to our new page. Okay, so the name of the page, for example, I'm giving here sample1.html is the name of the page. Okay, so how to connect means, we have to open the tag. So we can just give a paragraph here, just welcome to Twist, just a paragraph. Okay, now below that I'm giving the link here. So for the link, a tag. Okay, it can be small letter or capital, a tag, href equal to. So the main thing is our new file, which means whatever we are working, images.html and sample1.html, both are in the same folder. So no need to give the path, this path no need to give, just give the name of the file. For example, if the image, if this image was in this page, same page, which means both are in the same folder. No need to give this whole path, just give the image name, that's all. No need to give this whole path. Okay, that's another thing. That's with a hyperlink also it is applicable. So in the hyperlink we can give sample1.html. so I am just copying it. Okay, sample1.html. so here sample1.html. closing the double quotes. Now closing the tag. After that I said a link should be provided. So a text to click on should be provided, like this. Click here to visit. Same way we need to give something like that. So for that, I am giving visit trif. I am just giving that. After that you can close the a tag. Okay, so I created like this, a link will come. Okay, so we will just check what is happening. Okay, so we will go to the page, refresh it. In the page you can see here, you can see welcome to Tris, visit Tris, a link provided. So a link means it is usually in purple color. Okay, so when you click it will become immediately red, when you close it it will become purple again. Okay, so the link usually it's in blue color. I said purple earlier, it's blue color actually. And if you click it, immediately it will become red. That means it is active now. That link is active now. I will show you the difference. Let us reverse this gray color. Okay, so I am deleting this BG color. Okay, to see it more clearly. You can see this is in blue color. Okay, the link is in blue color. So if you click, it will open the other page. Okay, so I am just clicking. So if I click, you know, now this page is opened. That means it is linked. Okay, and you can click on the back button to click. Now this blue changed to purple. Okay, blue changed to purple. It's hard to actually recognize. If you take in Google also, if you search something in Google also, this is happening. Blue links will come. You will click it, you will open the page. If you come back, you can see the pages you visited will be in purple color. Okay, so it's a technique usually. It's a by default it is like that. Okay, and so that's simply a href. So if this page was in another folder, you have to copy the path, like I already shown in the image tag. Okay, so next. So here different applications are there. Already we studied this one, we already did link to a document called form on html on the same server in the same directory. So that means same server in the same directory means usually websites are hosting in another servers and we are taking from the server. We are a client. I am connected to internet means that I am a client. Okay, so it's usually like that. But here now we are doing in our computer. That means our computer is a local server. All the files are in our computer. So consider our computer as a local server. So this example already we did. Now link to a document called parent.html on the same server in the parent directory. That means another directory. Okay, it's in the another directory. That already I showed you in which folder it is residing. Okay, you understood, I think, on the like in which folder that path we have to copy and we have to paste it. Okay, now here link to a document called cat.html on the same server in the subdirectory. Okay, subdirectory means for example if you have another folder in the same directory, like okay, so if you have this images folder here, it's a subfolder of HTML, right? It's a subfolder of HTML. So if the page sample1.html is in the image, is in this particular folder, then you have to give like this. Okay, that image slash our page sample1.html. Okay, then if you give, it will come like this. So this way you can give links actually three ways. Now another useful thing is link to an external website. That means if you want to link your page to another website, you can give easily like this. Here one thing you can use, you have to use the URL. URL means the address of the web page. Okay, the address of the web page, and before that you have to use this HTTP full colon double slash. Okay, I will show that how to use. Now if we connect this code, if we take this code in our page, if you click on the link, it will go to the original website www.triscotain.com. So you can connect to different websites like that. Okay, so here one more attribute is showing, that is target. So target underscore blank. So what is the use of that? Means if you give target is equal to underscore blank, the new page, that is www.triscotain, will open in a new window. Okay, it will be in a new window. So that's how we will give. So we will just give this example. Okay, how to do that? Yeah, so I am connecting our school website to the page. Okay, so we will connect this link. I will just delete. Okay, here we will give another one instead of that. So here in the href we have to give, look, the full address of our website. Okay, means the triscotain.com website, then target is equal to underscore blank. This thing we have to give. Okay, here we can give double quotes, HTTP will give in small letter, full colon double slash www.triscotain.com. Okay, so and I gave the option visit tris. Okay, so if you need the link in a big letter or something, like another font or something, you can give this also. Here in our result, actually the visit link is in a small, like small letter, so I will just increase its size. Okay, so simply you can increase by giving h2 tag and just simply use it. Okay, that's all. Slash h2. Yeah, so it will be in a big size. Now we will go to the page, refresh it. You can see the visit option is here. If you put the scroll, means your mouse, you can see the hand, that means it's a link. And on the left corner, bottom left corner, you can see www.triscotain, that means that link is connected to Triscotain. So if you click on that, so I clicked, now it's waiting, the network is little bit slow, that's why. So our school website is coming in a new window. Okay, it's another window, look, home, Rajas, and also in a new window it is coming. Understood? So this way external websites can be connected with the help of this particular code. Okay, same code, this particular code. Now another option, link to an email address. You may have seen in many websites, please mail to us or mail your details to us, like that. Okay, or if you comment it, it will go as a mail like that. I will show. Okay, an example, let us check the school website itself. I think in our website it is not there. Yeah. Okay, Yeah, here look, these kind of facilities you may have seen, apply online kind of facilities. Okay, so in these kind of facilities, if you click on send, it will go to the school mail ID. Actually, because this send, this particular link is created like this. Okay, understood. This particular link is created like this. So in that email link, that means the link we discussed here, this one. Yeah, here the one problem is, when you want to create an email link, you have to create a whole lot of pages, what we saw in that Triskotem site. So in the current syllabus, the IGCSE syllabus, what we are learning, they will give a mail ID for you, and we have to only include this particular link in that page. It will not work actually, because for working you need the you need to give to from email address and all, then only the link will work. So here only your syllabus I am doing. So the thing about mail to is, we have to work a whole load, because we have to create a whole web page, forms and everything, then only this will work properly. Okay, you need that special database and all for that. So for here, for our question paper for IGCSE 0417 syllabus, they will give the mail ID and subject. We need to only type it down in the page what they are giving. Okay, so only that much we have to do. So like, for example, here they have given a mail ID like this. So you can give a href mail to that mail ID. You can include here in the question paper, they will give the mail ID. That mail ID you can include here. Then subject also you can give. So each words you can separate by the plus symbol. Okay, visitors, if you have now also, you can add plus now. This way you can give the subject link also. So this will give you the marks. Even though the page is not working, they need to know whether you understood the mail tag, whether you know the mail tag. Okay, so that is mail to, href mail to tag. Now another one is image link. So image link means, usually in a web page, like for example here, if you click on the visit tris, it will go there, it will go to the other page. Okay, it will go to the other page. It's usually like that. You click here, now it will open the other page. Now the internet is down, that's why it is showing like this. Yeah, now in the same way, if you click on an image, that image will take you to another page. Now if you click on the image, nothing will happen here, right? So that is what we call image link. Okay, so here same way, href the web page name, applynow.html or your page name, then inside the href you can give image tag. We have to combine the image tag as well as the normal a tag. Okay, so here I will just give that, I will just show that. So here I need to give this image. Okay, the image we already have, or we will add another image, no issue for that. So inside the a tag, instead of this, we can give an image. Okay, so I'm deleting it, and I will add another image there. Normal image tag we can give. So image, and here this Triskotem we can change to our sample.html. okay, yeah, sample1.html we will do that. sample1.html. okay, yeah, now in the image tag, so I am giving a tag here, creating a tag. Instead of a text like visit tris or something, instead of a text like visit tris, I am giving an image there. I am going to give an image there. Okay, so same way, image src is equal to, I need the image, right? So an image will be I'm giving this image. Okay, so just copy the image name. So and first you need to copy the address, right? So copy the address and give double quotes, paste it there. After that give a backslash, include a backslash here. Okay, then the image name you need. So I'm giving this image name, copy, paste, double quotes, close. Okay, so the image tag I gave here. So okay, yeah, so the image tag I gave here. So we gave the details here, href sample1.html details and all. Now we have to run it, launch in Chrome. Okay, now it came. You can see two images. This is the image tag, right? So whenever I put the mouse pointer here, you can see it is just a pointer. Okay, if you click also, nothing is happening, but this is the image link. So when I move the mouse pointer, you can see a hand symbol came. That means it is an image link. Okay, so if you click here, what will happen? It will take you to the other page. So that's how you will add image link to a page. Okay, so hyperlinks and images, I hope you understood, and how to mix those particular links together and all. So thank you for watching.